Yes, my name is Johan. I'm doing the advanced class in coding and I'm in grade 8. And this is my first project. It's called the Whack-A-Mole. So in the beginning of the game, you have to enter your name to start. In this, you can choose your difficulty, easy, medium, or hard. In this case, I'll choose easy. So what you basically have to do, you have to hit the Whack-A-Mole or tap on it with your mouse or your finger. And the score will increase by 10. This is the amount of seconds that is left. And just in case you want to know which level you clicked, it is given here, easy. So when you click on the screen and you miss the Whack-A-Mole, the score decreases by 8. No, 6. It decreases by 6.
Okay.
And then I'm just waiting for this to end.
That's okay, yeah. So what happens at the end of 1 minute?
Yes, ma'am. At the end of 1 minute, you will be taken to the game over screen where your score will be given along with your name. You have a choice whether you want to play again or you don't want to play again. In that case, you can just close the window and leave. So if you want to play again, you can play again.
I can choose the symmetric
card. Ma'am, it's not reinitialized.
That's fine. Start the next program. And this was a very good project by Johan. It's a calculator.
So this is the calculator project. It's a calculator. You can calculate numbers. It's obvious. So in this case, I'll take 6 plus 3, which is equal to 9. From multiplication, which is equal to 32. So division 9 divided by 3.
What happens to percentage? What happens to 10% of 20? Can you please do that for me?
Yes, ma'am. Sure. 20 is equal to 2.
Good job. Okay. So very good. Next one.
Then my third project, it is the lateral surface area, total surface area and volume project. So in this project, you can choose whether you want to calculate the volume, total surface area and lateral surface area of a cylinder, cube, cone or cuboid. In this case, I'll take cube. Side is 7. Calculate it. In case you want to go back to calculate another, like to calculate the volume, you take the volume of a cube. It's 27. Yes, it is. Then we can take the total surface area, the cone, 36 and 1. 316.83. And the last project which I have, which I made recently, is the treasure hunt.
Treasure hunt was a game that he conceived it himself and he's done it.
In this game, what I did was, it's a treasure hunt where you have to find the lucky coin. This is the lucky coin. Again, you have levels to choose from, just like the mole. It is very similar to the mole, except the coin doesn't move in different positions. It just remains in one position and it is hidden. And you have 5 lives to try and get it. So the coin is hidden in any one of these. In any one of these 16 holes. So click here. I have 4 lives left. The game starts with 5 lives. And my time ran out, my lives ran out. So when my lives hit 0, that means you have lost the game. You can choose to start over or quit. If you want to quit, this will be displayed. Thank you for playing, madam or mister.
Okay. Thank you. Good job. And Ryan?
So our first project was the Whack-A-Mole. So first, there's a button which is play game, and then we enter a name.
Ryan is the best,
okay. And then there are 3 levels, easy, medium, hard. And
he's going to the hard level.
Okay. And it displays your the level.
Yeah. And try clicking on it.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah,
you too hard for yourself, huh?
And you will never be able to beat this level because I made it really. And then the timer's up. It keeps on decreasing. So it's totally 60 seconds. Just Oh, ma'am, should I let it get wasted 30 seconds or?
That's okay. Click on something. Try clicking on something. At least get one addition point.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Good.
Clicking on one area gets me one addition. I need my actual mouse to do this.
That's fine.
Oh, yes, I got a score of minus 300. So after the 60-second timer gets over with the score
so
of
minus. So basically, you are making it randomized, right? It doesn't stay on time. It randomizes every 2 seconds.
Yes, and then okay. It's displayed. Good job, Ryan James. Your score is... this okay. Press this button if you got a score below minus 10, and then there's a play again button.
Okay, good.
So now for our next one is the calculator, which took us almost a year. Okay, anyways, let's go. So this AC, which is to rub everything off, division, addition,
reset.
Multiplication, yeah, reset in multiplication, division, I forgot the other sign, and equal to. So now let's take a number 123 plus 36. It gives us the answer 149 and it displays this just in case if you forgot it.
Okay.
Or you can take like a very big number and add it to a very big number and it will give a very big number.
And then what happened? Yeah, very good. So it's
yeah, after
there.
This, then we AC it. Bye-bye.
Reset it.
Yeah, reset. If you ever need a calculator, just... open this app.
Okay. I mean, we'll sell your app.
Yes. And now this is this is for the volume, total surface area, and large surface area. So when you go to the volume, there are four shapes here. Cylinder, cube, cuboid, cone. So I like here. So then we have to enter the radius side, 24, 25. Then we calculate or we can go back. So now we have a cylinder, radius side, same thing. 34, 36, calculate, and we get 130674.2 for cubics and units. So if you want to go back and go to total surface area or lateral surface area, we can do that.
Okay.
So
I have a question for you, Ryan. What did you learn during the process of volume, surface area, and lateral surface area? How are they different?
The thing I learned in volume surface area, we use cubic meters, and in total surface area, we use square meters, I think.
Okay, square meters?
Yeah, square units. Yes, that's what I learned.
Do you want to give a sneak peek of your new project that you're working on?
No.
I know it's work in progress.
Yes, it's a work in progress, and it's 73 lines of code. Pretty good. Okay, then when we run it, there's a start button, and this bug goes and hides in any of these four, and if I press this and I'm wrong, it says you lose and it shows where it was hiding. And then I made another game. Why is it not working? Yes,
okay.
I forgot to rename.
It is work in progress. It's okay.
Yes, ma'am, it's a work in progress.
Yeah, what is the importance of writing comments and everything?
The importance of writing comments is like if Isa comes from India and he wants to look at my code and he does not know what is there, he will look at my comments and say, oh, yes, this is what we have to do.
Perfect. Okay. Thanks, Ryan. So how many can you click? So you didn't explain this game.
Oh, yes. So this game is basically about the bug hiding somewhere. And since we don't like bugs that much, we hit it. We like, okay, anyway, so then it shows us where the bug was hiding. So I made two games because my brother said this is a very small game and you should make a little bit more. So I made two games. Then ma'am said I should make one more game. So I'm planning to make that game.
Very good. So, okay, make it and start selling it.
Yes, ma'am.
Thanks so much, Ryan. That was really nice.